If you really want to learn and if you want to take that step, you have to come here.
It's very personable. There's lots of online media that you can check out, but this interactive aspect is it's quite good.
I've gotten a No-Till Farmer magazine forever, and it's probably the best publication in agriculture. I'm just bound and determined I was going to finally make it, and it's not been a disappointment.
Not a lot of no-till and cover crop use where I am, so it's good to come down here and talk to other producers who are already doing it.
I showed up here by myself, and it was my first time. Very, very friendly, very inviting, and that was a relief for me, being the first time here.
You get refreshed on things and learn something new every day.
I'm finding it very interesting with the diversity of the topics and just the general information that everyone is sharing.
The value you can bring to your farm, what you're going to learn, the people you're going to meet, that's going to surpass the cost of the conference in no time, and you're really going to enjoy it, and I would definitely recommend it to people.
Like I say, we're still learning. I've been here for 24 years, and I learn something every year.
I'm really interested in the way that we can continue moving ag forward and love to be able to provide the science and research to farmers to be able to do that.
Still, when I come back, I love hearing everyone, but still hearing farmers speak of what they're doing is probably my favorite.
Like, I just came from classrooms, a much smaller setting, and that's when you can really hear the producer side of things, and they all just kind of run off each other, and that's, for me, it's gold.
It teaches you to think out of the box a little bit, kind of figure it out, see what'll adapt for our area.
We don't have as much no-till going on in our area as we do in some areas here, so it's about getting information and sharing it.
I've heard a lot of work, like with Chalmer Cornheads, and seen some of his data. Getting to hear his presentations in person, as well as Ray Archuleta, you get to learn a lot.
I just like coming to hear the different speakers, and networking is a big deal, going to the different roundtables and different classrooms, hearing what people are trying new. I came this year to try how to find out to plant green into rye grass.
I always tell people you have to network, and there's not a better place to network than.
It's an excellent place to learn. Pass on information that some of us old gray-haired guys have learned different techniques and things over the years, and just want to pass it on and share.
It's a great networking opportunity, and then I can take home new ideas from the speakers that I hear too.
You can only read so much online and learn that way, but actually coming here and talking to people from all across the country and learning their techniques and how you can apply it to your farm.
First year I came and met some guys from Iowa, and every year we come together, we always have dinner Wednesday night of the conference, so it's always nice to get in touch with those guys.
Back home, you don't necessarily tell all of your secrets to your neighbors, but here's the time when everyone's willing to share.
Lunchtime, I just happened to sit beside someone who is a no-tiller, but also runs a crop consulting business. And, you know, we exchange cards at the end because, you know, there'll be future discussions there.
Well, everybody here, they are blessed with a burden that they're trying to grow a crop somewhere across this nation. And just because something works for me may not mean they work for him, but I may take something he's got and be able to apply it to me.
And if I catch something here, I'll bring it back home, put all the stuff together. It's just, it explodes much faster and into a level that I never thought I was ever gonna get to, really.
I would absolutely recommend it. It's pretty welcoming because everybody's friendly. That's good stuff.
While you're eating dinner, you get to learn a lot with no-tillers. They might have tried some things that I have, and they've also done some things that I haven't, and I can learn from their past experiences.
I've been no-tilling for 37 years, but talking to other people and some of the presenters have given me different lines to think about.
Just don't be afraid to get out of your comfort zone. You come down here and you meet a lot of people who are trying a lot of cool things, and you can't be afraid to try something different.
If you can just take one thing back to your farm, I think it's worth the trip.
The whole way of thinking, the no-till practice and ways to do it better is really what I'm going to take home.
It's been a great experience since here. I hope to come back year after year after year.